Oh, yes? Do they come on horses with rifles and say,
yes, I can go. Do your job.
And do you, gringo, take off your ring, drop your wallet into a blanket, spread over the ground, and walk away? I hear Mexicans are taking your jobs away. Do they sneak into towns at night? And as you're walking home with a whore, do they mug you, a knife at your throat, saying,
I want your job.
Even on TV, an asthmatic leader crawls turtle heavy, leaning on an assistant, and from a nest of wrinkles on his face, a tongue paddles through flashing waves of light bulbs of cameramen, rasping. They're taking our jobs away.
That's right, a lot of people up there can't get jobs. They can't get jobs. Because there are no jobs. Mexico has our jobs. They all have a job. When Mexico sends its people, they're not sending their best.
Well, I've gone about trying to find them, asking just where the hell are these fighters. The rifles I hear sound in the night are white farmers shooting blacks and browns whose ribs I see jutting out, and starving children. I see the poor marching for a little work. I see small white farmers selling out to clean-suited farmers living in New York. Who've never been on a farm, don't know the look of a hoof or the smell of a woman's body bending all day long in the fields. I see this, and I hear only a few people got all the money in this world. The rest count their pennies to buy bread and butter. Below that cool green sea of money, millions and millions of people fight to live, search for pearls in the darkest depths of their dreams, hold their breath for years, trying to cross poverty just to have something. The children are dead already. We are killing them. And that is what America should be saying. On TV, in the streets, in offices, should be saying, we aren't giving the children a chance to live. Mexicans are taking our jobs, they say instead. What they really say is, let them die. And the children too.